Hello everyone, welcome to the TSS. In the last class we had discussed how many ways of arguments, how many types of arguments are there, like this: position arguments, keyword arguments, default arguments and variable length arguments. Now we will discuss the first type of argument called positional argument, friends. Okay, so let us discuss positional arguments. So in positional arguments, the input data which you are feeding to the function as an argument is very much depend upon its position, friends. Okay, here you can see the function is defined like this: function sub. Sub means subtraction. So at the function definition itself, I had declared two parameters, right? Number one, number two. That is, two inputs should be given by the user. At the function definition itself, I declared these two as parameters, and then block was opened. And you please understand, the parameters, arguments, both are interchangeably used. You don't get confused with that. So num1 and num2 both are declared, and what it means is, while calling the function called sub, you need to give compulsory two arguments. That means two inputs you have to give, right? So num1 and num2, and then the function block, the statements block began. So I had written like this with string concatenation for demonstration purposes, right? So num1 is equal to, it will be typed as it is, plus here it is, acts as a string concatenation operator, and then num1 means the number which will be given by the user will be stored in num1, and eventually it is displayed here, and then num2 also displayed here, and the result is num1 minus num2, number 1 minus number 2. Subtraction will be performed and result will be stored in the result variable, and the return is resulted, right? Now, so our main focus is how positional arguments work. What is positional arguments is all about, right? Now, if you call the function like sub and arguments list as 20, 10, that means 20 is in the first place, 10 is in the second place, right? Now, correspondingly, positionally, 20 is in the first place, no? So the first place will be goes and store in the first place variable or parameter, right? This is a dummy variable, okay, inside the function, please remember. Num1, so num1 here, it is located in positionally at the first place. Here positionally 20 is at the first place, so here also first place, there also first place. No, so 20 is going to function and stored in the num1 variable, and the second place 10 is goes and stored in the num2 variable. That is, it is because it is in second place, this is also second place. So positionally, correspondingly, first place will go to the first place parameter, second place argument will go and store in the second place parameter, right? Now accordingly the defined logic will performed. So num1 is having 20, num2 is having 10, so num1 20 minus num2 10, 20 minus 10 10 is the result. Result will be returned for user, right? So this is the logic. Now if you by mistake if you change this order 10 20, then num1 will become what? 10. Num2 will become 20. Then so num1 minus num2, now what will happen? 10 minus 20 will happen, that means minus 10 will be the result. So this is very important, that while giving the positional arguments method, whatever you want to give, that positional positions should be considered as very important, because the logic will change, right? So if it is subtraction, then minus values will come. If it is division, then if you want to divide 20 by 10, if you forget to give your arguments positionally correct, then what will happen? Instead of 20 by 10, 10 by 20 will be processed here, because this logic doesn't change. If you change this positional arguments, so number 1 and number 2 will interchanged. So instead of 20 divided by 10, 10 divided by 20 will be performed here. So here I had performed subtraction operation. In case of division, it will be like that. So you can extend the same theory to any set of examples, friends. Okay, so let us demonstrate it practically. So in the functions, okay, we have already function defined from the last classes. I am making use of that function only. Function, say I am taking it as say division. Okay, division number 1, number 2. Okay, so number 1 stored in A, number 2 stored in B. Let me, so I need to demonstrate the numbers. No, okay, console.log, what, console.log num1 is equal to, then string concatenation operator num1. Okay, num1 means this will be printed here, and similarly number 2 also, right? Number 2, then what? So the result is num 1 divided by num 2. Okay, so this is a division operator, normal division operator, coefficient division operator. So num 1 divided by num 2 is the logic here, right? And the result is stored in the result variable, it is written. Okay, now the function name is division. Now if you want to perform division, some 15 by say 3, okay, 15 by 3. Now what we have to give? Now div, okay, 15 is the first one, 3 is the second one, because inside the logic what we have defined, number 1 divided by number 2. So number 1 is 15, so that 15 will be stored in number 1. 3 is color, because it is in the second place, it will go on store in the second place parameter. So like that, positionally it is in first place and num1 is in the first place, that's why the first place argument will go on store in the first place argument only, the second place argument will go on store in the second place argument only. Okay, if you interchange it here also, the numbers will interchange. Okay, let us see the output now. Let us assign to some variable called x. Okay, so we can do it. After performing, the result was returned to the x variable, and that variable is printed. Let me clear the console. Now I am executing the function. Here you can see num1 is 15, right? So 15 is stored in the num1, and due to the result of this code, it was printed, num1 is equal to 15. Console.log num2, so num2, it is 3, it was stored in the num2 and it is printed as 3. And the result of the operation, 15 by 3, okay, so the coefficient is what, 5, so the result is returned as 5. Okay, now if you change the arguments by mistake, okay, now let us print this also, console.log y. Okay, saved, here you can see this is the first call. For the first call, num1 is 15, num2 is 3. Okay, num1 is 15, num2 is 3. So by mistake what you did is what, num1 and num2, so here you have interchanged that one. 3 will store in num1, 15 will store in num2. Even to what will happen, 3 by 15 division will be divided. So this is, this result is for first one and this result is for second one. So here 0.2, instead of you need to get 5 as a result, but it is 0.2. so you need to go back and trace where the mistake is. So here the mistake is, because in the positional arguments method, the position of the argument you are placing is plays very important role, friends. That is the principle, right? Okay. In the next class, we will discuss about next is keyword arguments, friends. Okay. Till then, bye bye. Yours, Veera, signing off. Thank you for listening.